Okay. Well, our next guests really need no introduction, but I'm going to give them one anyway. So Bob Geldof and Libbi Gorr have joined forces to ruffle some feathers with a brand new radio show. It's day four and they've taken time out to join us live from Melbourne. Great to see you both. So this new radio show is on a network called Disrupt Radio. What do you want to disrupt?
Everything.
And I need to say, when you say Sir Bob Geldof and Libbi Gorr just so easily, it just sounds too permanent for me.
Put your head there. It works. What can I say? 4 days.
It's just magic.
What are you thinking coming to Australia in the winter, Bob?
Oh, man, it's horrible. Oh. I mean, you know, it's really... Coming to us... I have to translate, Tristan, bear with me. Coming to Australia in winter. See, she gets it. You have to talk like that, you know. So, no, because I came down from Tahiti.
Because he was on a boat with someone like, you know, it wasn't Roger Taylor or someone's boat. No. Mick Jagger.
This is what I have to deal with. She makes this stuff up.
So when they said they wanted to get like an entrepreneur and a knight to launch the station, I put in an order for Branson. Anyway, keep going.
Well, because, look, this might be day four, might be your last day.
No, we've got one more.
You're getting the plot now, guys.
Yeah. You know. I listened in this morning. You sound great together. You sound like old buddies, I have to say. You were chatting a bit about AI. So, Bob, as a musician, are you afraid of what is to come in the music biz with AI?
No, not really. It'll just be like anything. Musicians tend to be first movers with new technologies. You rip open the cardboard box, you plug it in, you see what it can do, and then you use it and discard it. We tried that on the show today. Libbi thought it would be hilarious to have Adele sing one of my songs. Then she thought it would be hilarious to have Darragh Braithwaite, someone I've never heard of,
to sing one of our songs. Hey, steady on, mate. You know, we don't diss Darragh Braithwaite in this country.
Cannot say that to a Gen X
woman. We did have ChatGPT do a review of all our shows. She got rinsed.
Not completely. You know,
they just wanted me. The computer wanted me.
But, Ange, I sang a good song. Silicon chip inside her head.
No, Tristan knows that silly old chip inside her.
I thought you were on my team. Come here, Libbi. How's this week been? Has Bob lived up to his image or what you taught?
What did I taught? I thought...
Tristan, like, what the... This is impossible.
Listen, it's ridiculous, isn't it?
I have to just say, what a darkly exciting thrill. I feel like I took a new job and then they said, oh, by the way, in your first week, we're going to throw at you an international, global superstar, activist, pop star, and he can do whatever he likes with your program, whatever he likes with you, throw you upside down, turn you inside out. You're going to do things you never thought you would do or anticipated that you would enjoy. But sadly and strangely, I am enjoying it and I can't wait for
it
to be over.
She loves being tossed upside down.
It's just... Actually, you know...
She wants me. She
come
wants
and get me!
You know, it's that thing. It's
Ange!
The charisma.
I'm doing what I can, Lib. I'll try. Yeah. I'll try.
But it's like you guys. We just get paid to turn it on, you know? And then it's back
he's crossed
to
his legs the other way now. But before, he was thoroughly angled towards me. Yeah. He just enjoys the seduction.
Well, and why wouldn't he? He's only human. Bob, you became a household name with Live Aid in 1985.
No, what? Actually.
You had a really good song.
I know that, but Live Aid was pretty, pretty massive. Does the world still enrage you?
Yeah, I mean, part of the thing about Disrupt Radio is that Ben, the guy who's been working on it for 5 years, just believes that the news has become so binary, so shouty, so about really nothing, and that's a function of 24-hour news media that the politicians respond to, that all the research he did into it over 5 years says that that a different generation just want different things. They want to be told what's going on. They want discussions about it. It's about the now and what's coming rather than about old stuff from the past.
And it's kind of like literacy, you know, like it's literacy in terms of mindset and that confidence that you actually can change things yourself. If you lean in, you're so rude. You are so rude. I mean, anyway, so... thank goodness Bob will be gone next week, and then I'll have a great array of co-hosts.
I just want to play this out now for a little bit, huh?
I tell you, when we came in today into the Melbourne studio, we went up, but she pressed the lift.
We didn't know where it was. No, because
the publicist was sitting up here. Notice, go back to floor one and go to the intercom, and we'll buzz you up. So we get out of the lift. There's a hand sanitizer machine.
You put his face in the hand sanitizer to talk to us. I feel like we're kind of...
She thought that was the intercom.
And Jackie O, with smarts, kind of flipped backwards. Anyway, it's a kind of week-long affair that will end.
Tomorrow.
And...
we're out of here.
We'll be happy.
Libby, has anything been off limits?
Yes.
What, precisely?
Me.
No, that's it. Any topic off limits?
No, actually, what's been actually interesting about it is that we've kind of left the microphones open. So we have... Bob did come and disrupt the whole place in terms of what had been planned and what we were planning to do. And it is meant to be progressive talk, an adult progressive talk. So we're not actually talking about celebrities and their impact upon the world and give us a call and tell us what you had for breakfast. It's actually been stimulating conversation, some of which I understand, Ange. I know. Who would know? Bob apparently has 30 honorary law degrees that they've just given him. I tried to tell him that I worked for mine and earned
it. Yeah, you've got a real one.
He wasn't impressed. So you know what the dynamic is.
I am.
I know, darling. Well, we'll do some catching up later.
Yeah, exactly. Wow.
And Bob, tell us about the music. You're still making music. You still love the music.
Oh, he's just got his band back together.
Yeah, I'm going back tomorrow because I've got to do a couple of festivals and good few throughout the summer, about 13 festivals we do, and that's my favourite way to do it, you know.
But that's just a passion project for you, isn't it? The music, like, you make your money. You do business. You're good at business.
Yeah, but I wouldn't do it for free. I don't know why.
you don't do anything for free. No. He wouldn't even buy me a present because it was going to cost $14. No, because he likes his freebies.
No,
She collects royal
memorabilia.
Yes, she does.
She has a Fergie plate.
No, I don't have a Fergie plate. I've got a Diana plate and a Queen Mother plate.
She has Fergie clothes.
You like Fergie. You know Fergie. You are so
rude. Fergie's lovely.
Get me Branson. Next time I want Branson.
I love it. This is why these two make great radio.
Please don't talk about it with any sense of permanency. Next week, I'm on air with my proper team,
It's like a relationship, really.
No. Don't be mean or else I'll do it.
What? Do what? Do what?
He knows.
He would tell us.
He knows.
This is why I made up Elle McFeast, Ange.
Yes, indeed.
I'd forgotten. Remember I told you I'd forgotten?
Yeah, some people do Live Aid, others do Elle McFeast. Okay?
Oh, my God, you are so arrogant. And, you know, the cause of the female voice is something that I am very pleased to have played a small part in elevating against the patriarchy like you. Yeah, we know that you're big time. Yeah. You don't have to prove it.
Global, international, megastar.
Whatever.
And it's your humility that strikes us at its core. So, Bob, we'll leave you to compare.
Charles and Diana or Wills and Kate at the moment at Ascot? Like, look at us. We start off like this and then by the end of the conversation...
Well, we'll leave you to compare the number of law degrees, honorary or other, that you might have. Meantime, you can find Disrupt Radio at disrupt.radio. So, Bob Geldof and Libbi Gorr, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Cheers.
All the best. Take care.
Bye.
See ya.